Welcome back to K-Ratio's Weekend Preview. I'm Kyle Lintner, and I'm here today to provide actionable insight for the future, not recap the past. In this week's episode, things are slowly returning to normal down in Texas, but the reverberations continue to disrupt well beyond the Lone Star State and in a very big way. We'll break down what that means for you this week, but first, let's take a look at where the freight market currently stands. Tender volumes exploded 13% higher from last week to 15,318, the highest print since peak holiday on December 5, 2020, and a head-scratching 57% higher year over year. Tender rejections, however, actually declined ever so slightly from 27.3% to 26.9%, which means when we put the two metrics together, we're not just seeing rejected tenders amplify the reading, but an implied accepted tender index 19% higher than last week. That drastic volume surge, coupled with a severely disrupted domestic supply chain, propelled Truckstop's national spot rate index up 26 cents from last week, a 9% jump good for $3.11 a mile, the highest since the all-time high holiday peak of $3.22 back on January 3rd. That sharp spot jump was good enough to narrow the gap between DAT spot and contract down to 6 cents from 14 cents just 3 weeks ago. Even more impressive was the sharp rise in reefer rates, a 12% jump from last week to $3.74 a mile, 73 cents more than just 3 weeks ago, and an unbelievable $1.44 higher year over year. Adding to that, as measured by DAT, spot reefer rates have once again surpassed contract and by a 5 cent margin. We have not even hit the mythical produce season yet, and the demand for reefer trailers is bordering on total chaos within the domestic supply chain. Last week, we highlighted the domino effect cancellations in Dallas would cause in other major transportation cities, and forewarned of an impending capacity crunch in Dallas once weather conditions normalized. Both came to fruition and both persist, though to differing degrees. Unfortunately for much of the country, the second order effect of the Texas disruptions continues, which puts the entire national supply chain at risk for further complications and spot rate surges. This chart of tender rejections for Dallas in blue set against tender volumes in orange gives us everything we need to see. Rejections are still high, but easing from the peak, even though volumes have skyrocketed, indicating that the imbalance of loads versus capacity is moderating. Outbound Dallas rates 5 to 15% higher across the board, including 13% higher on backhaul dominant lanes like Dallas to LA, will do that. Trucks will go where price and sometimes K-ratio tell them to go. This chart of outbound rejections for the other major transportation markets brings attention to the differing circumstances. LA in purple has moderated since its jump, and Atlanta in blue has plateaued, but Chicago in green is turning up again, while Harrisburg in yellow has not stopped its ascent. This is what we warned of last week when other markets are asked to pick up the volume dropped after a market like Dallas shuts down. These cities simply do not have trucks sitting around waiting to pick up excess volume and suffer their own imbalances as a result. This is how a weather event in Dallas can cause national spot rates to jump 13% in just 2 weeks and force everyone to rethink refrigerated contract rates. What does this mean for freight this week? Carriers, the Dallas effect is over. In fact, inbound cancellations for Dallas now exceed outbound by 3%. There are now too many trucks in the area. The aforementioned Chicago and Harrisburg are the markets currently short on trucks. Brokers, these are the same ever-changing dynamics you need to be aware of. Last week's hot market is this week's cold market. First, there's not enough trucks. Now there's too many trucks. Price these overcorrections accordingly, both in what you quote the shipper and what you offer the carrier. Shippers, remember that chart from last week about the import cargo volumes at the Port of LA? Well, it's back and it's even worse. Get ahead of this before produce season begins or reefer spot rates will start with a 4 and not a 3. To stay current with everything freight, follow us on LinkedIn or for more information on all of our products, including our award-winning freight intelligence platform so your margins don't end up where they are today, check us out at k-ratio.com. Please stay safe, and thanks again for watching.